All truly great thoughts are conceived by walking. This quote was said by Friedrich Nietzsche. Honestly, it's probably not true. I would say that some truly great thoughts have been conceived on the toilet or in the shower, but I would say this is true about 85% of the time. I have found no greater pleasure in life than in just taking a 15-minute walk with the sole purpose being just to walk. That's the thing about stuff trying to get you to be better on the internet these days. It's always what you should do, the actions you should take, having you change something drastically in what you do. But really, what you don't do is as equally as important as what you do. Technically, yes, going for a walk is doing something, but there are so many things that you end up not doing when you decide to go for that walk. You get a heightened peace of mind, you recenter yourself, you shift your focus to the present moment, and that means you don't worry, stress, or get angry anymore. You also might feel the overwhelming urge to procrastinate something. If you decide to take a walk instead of do that work, this is 100% not a form of procrastination. This is what I believe. I would rather call it a way to get you back on course to doing that thing you need to do, but to do it even better. Imagine you're on a train track, and in the distance you see another track that diverges far from the one you're on. Let's call that the procrastination track. And then on the other side, there's a very small train track that diverges from the original, but ends up coming back to the original path after a short period of time. That's the if I go for a walk track. If you decide to do unbeneficial procrastination, such as watching TV or going on your phone, you will never return to that original train track, which is where work gets done. But if you decide to go on that hypothetical walk track, you will come back to that track with a newfound appreciation for your work. And you are able to focus on that track a lot longer with a clearer mind. I hope that makes sense to you, but basically what I'm trying to say is if you feel stuck on something you're working on, going for a walk can completely eradicate that. But not doing garbage procrastination stuff, like your phone, like watching TV, or any other nonsense. But let's get back to that original quote that walking is where great thoughts arise. This is true on so many levels. There's something about going for a walk that stirs the creative pot in your mind and has you thinking of new ideas and ways of figuring out things that were previously unavailable to you. This is probably because you could consider it as a form of meditation based on your intentions with the walk, and I'll go over that very soon. A study done by Stanford University researchers highlights the importance of walking for creativity and problem solving. After conducting 4 experiments, they confirmed that walking indoors or outdoors improved participants' ability to think creatively. And these positive effects continued even after they sat down to do inventive work. Walking opens up the free flow of ideas, and it is a simple and robust solution to the goals of increasing creativity and increasing physical activity, the researchers noted. In fact, compared to sitting, walking ramped up the participants' creative output during cognitive exercises by about 60%. The researchers surmised that moving puts people in a better mood, which sets the stage for creative thinking. In addition, focusing on movement is a distraction from linear thinking, which then frees up walkers' minds to wander to new ideas. This distraction is a huge reason why walking is super beneficial for both anxiety and stress relief too. Just think about it. What are the most pleasant and tranquil times in your life that you can think of? Probably when you were out in nature just enjoying what is. And you can have objectives with your walk. You can go on your walk with the intention that you want to have really deep thoughts about a certain topic. That does work, but I think if you're going for stress relief and anxiety specifically, you should focus on mindfulness. This means taking the time to look at all the colors, textures, and sounds that are going on around you.
Also, I don't suggest walking around with a massive camera and tripod because it's definitely not relaxing.
Feel your feet touch the ground with each step you take. Focus on your inward and outward breaths. Feel the movement in every part of your body and just allow yourself to be. And you'll find that when you walk back into the house, most of the problems you had when you walked out of the house have lessened or either gone away completely. This means that when you do decide to actually sit down and get back to your work again, your mind will be a lot less shifty. You won't lose attention as easily on the task at hand because you won't be worrying about other things or other people or all the important shit you have to do today and how you have to do the dishes and probably sweep the floor and maybe I need to take another walk. All jokes aside though, it will definitely be easier for you to stay more focused. Now, as to how long you want this walk to last, I guess that's really up to you. I personally like 15 to 20 minute walks. I feel like you get a lot of benefits with that, and it's not so much of an exercise as if you were to do it for like 30 minutes to an hour. But if you're trying to get two benefits for the price of one, then taking a walk for like 30 minutes to an hour is a great way to get the same benefits if you took a short walk while also burning calories and getting a good exercise in. So do yourself a favor and start walking at least 10 minutes a day. Maybe listen to some music during it, but please, please do not look down at your phone as this will completely defeat the purpose.
All right, so I just got back from my walk. Obviously, you can tell it's really freaking hot here, but it definitely wasn't the full experience because I did have to film this video, but nonetheless, it was still very relaxing. And if you enjoyed this video and you got something out of it, all you gotta do is leave a like for me. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.